I have proof that my golden child sister wants my boyfriend and parents don't care. I live with said sister. She started college this summer and my parents asked if she could live with me because 1, she was going to school in the same city that I work in and 2, I was looking for a roommate anyway. We're not that close and I'm not a big fan of my parents, but I agreed because it seemed like a way to get us closer and she wouldn't be able to afford an apartment on her own. Every time I bring my boyfriend over to the apartment and we hang out in the common areas, cooking dinner or watching Netflix in the living room, my sister Hannah deliberately seems to hang out only in her underwear. Sometimes she will blatantly walk into our line of sight in her thong and tank top. My BF, of 3 years, handles it like a champ and looks elsewhere. I have explicitly told Hannah it's inappropriate to be walking around in her underwear with company over, and she never does this to anyone but him, and to cut it out. But she says he's like family so he shouldn't care and she just wants to be comfortable in her own space. Whenever we go into my bedroom, she will find excuses to knock, barge in, or otherwise interrupt-sexy times or not. She'll complain that she's lonely and wants the three of us to hang out, but only has this desire when she sees that we've gone into my bedroom. Or she'll make excuses as to why she needs one of us right now. One time she asked him to go into her room to kill a spider. I've told her to leave us alone when we go in there but she doesn't effing listen. He's told me that when I'm not around, in the bathroom or doing something else out of earshot, Hannah will come into the room and try to initiate all sorts of casual talk about intimacy with him. What's your favorite position? Mine's X. Or I bet all the girls were after you before you met up. How many girls have you hooked up with? Boys in my school always wanted to hook up with me. Or she will try to model outfits and ask if he thinks she looks hot. According to him, he either flat out ignores her or says he's not interested in talking about this with her. Finally, I went into her room the other day to retrieve my makeup and perfume, which she keeps stealing, and saw her Facebook was open on her laptop. I noticed that one of the chats had pictures of my boyfriend in it, which is why I read it. She was chatting with her best friend and the conversation was, Hannah, OMG, he's coming over today less than 3. Hannah, wanna come with me to the mall? I have to buy something sexy. Friend, OMG, you crazy girl. Isn't he old as flol? Hannah, WTF lol 24 isn't old. Hannah, he's so effing sexy I have to show you his pics. She then proceeded to share pictures of my boyfriend. These were not pictures from Facebook, but candid pictures of him that he clearly wasn't aware were being taken. Standing in our kitchen, napping on the couch, and even one of him on the street. Like some kind of crazy stalker. I told him about all of this and ever since then we have been together exclusively at his apartment and I've been staying over. Ultimately it's much nicer for us to have privacy. But I'm pissed that I have to cede my apartment to my teen sister because she has no respect for boundaries and apparently just wants to sleep with my boyfriend. I also feel like she is way too old for this shit. She's 18, not 15. I have no idea what to do here. I want to chew her out, but I've chewed her out over this in the past and apparently it did nothing. I'm at the end of my rope with her. If she wasn't my sister living in a new city, I would have kicked her out by now. As it is, I don't know if I should give her a warning, talk to my parents about it, but I know they will take her side. It is part of the reason why we aren't close. Or confront her with my boyfriend and have him tell her in no uncertain terms that it will never happen. Moving out isn't an option. I have a lease until next year, and I will not lose money and move out of my apartment because my sister can't effing control herself. She wouldn't be able to afford the apartment on her own anyway and would have to move out in the end, too. Update, my sister, 18F, is trying to seduce my, 24F, boyfriend, 24M. Out of the three main options - talk to my parents, confront my sister, or have my boyfriend shut her down - I decided to take 2. I contacted my parents first. Which was very difficult for me, and told them about what had been going on and that I was going to kick my sister out. I said it in a no arguments way, just a statement of fact that her behavior was completely unacceptable and that I had given her many chances in talking to her about it. I said I was telling them first so my kicking her out wouldn't come out of the blue for them and they could help her find someplace else to live if they wanted to. I did not send the screenshots of her FB convo because 1, I never took the screenshots and 2, I didn't feel any need to prove anything to them. It really felt like my decision whether they believed me or not. To my surprise, my parents actually believed my side of the story. Though not for the reasons you would think. 1. There had apparently been an incident at a recent family reunion that I didn't know about because I'd been unable to go. Our close cousin, B, who is 1 year older than me, brought her boyfriend to our annual family reunion to introduce him to everyone for the first time. Apparently Hannah shamelessly and openly flirted with B's BF in front of everybody - in front of B, in front of our parents, in front of B's parents, all of our aunts and uncles. I don't know exactly what Hannah did, but according to B, who I asked about it after, she was very obvious about it, trying to touch him a lot, sitting next to him whenever B got up to go somewhere else, etc. It was just very obvious. Everyone witnessed it and it was the gossip of the family for that entire day. My aunt and uncle, B's parents, were disgusted with her behavior and judged my parents for allowing Hannah to behave that way. All of a sudden my parents cared about what she was doing, because now it was affecting their reputation with the family, the most important thing to them. So apparently they were pissed at her for what had happened and had taken her car away for a few months prior to her coming to live here. 2. My parents don't want anything to endanger my relationship with my boyfriend because they consider him to be a catch, white, handsome, going to law school, and want us to get married and have smart babies. So they don't want Hannah to ruin that. My parents said they would talk to Hannah and beat it into her head that she could no longer act that way and that she was close to effing up her living situation and our relationship. They begged me to give her a second chance and to give her time to change once they talked to her. I told them I'd think about it. But once we hung up, I decided I didn't trust them to actually talk to her. Call it 18 years of experience. Well, whether they talked to her or didn't. The very next day, Hannah posted something on her Facebook to the tune of "Sometimes you can't let other people get in the way of love." So I sat her down and decided to have a talk with her myself. I told Hannah that if she didn't cut out her behavior immediately, I was going to kick her out. I told her that I knew about everything and that it sickened me that she would not only disrespect me by trying to seduce my boyfriend, but that she would freely backstab her own sister just to get with a guy. I told her that it made me feel disgusted knowing that she had a childish infatuation with my boyfriend, but that even if she did have feelings she couldn't help, she needed to learn how to control them like an adult and respect me, my relationship, and my home. Hannah mouthed off and said that my boyfriend was going to leave me anyway because I didn't put enough effort in looking good for him. I don't wear makeup every day, only on special occasions or on dates when I want to look nice for him, and my clothes are pretty plain, and that there were dozens of women in this city that could catch his eye. Then she said that she didn't have to listen to me. Fuck you. You're not that much older than me. You're not my mom. She said, word for word, I'm not a kid anymore. I can do whatever the fuck I want. Surprisingly, I kept my cool and told her that was true. There were adult consequences to her actions. Consequences which could range from getting kicked out and having to move back home to getting her ass beat. She was in the real world and couldn't get away with her shit anymore. She said I couldn't kick her out because it was illegal and that she could do whatever she wanted. And doing whatever she wanted meant being herself around my boyfriend. So I told her that she had 30 days to evict the apartment. She stormed off. I contacted the landlord and made sure that everything was square. She's not on the lease, so they didn't give a shit, and told my parents that it was final. My sister had to be out of the apartment by the end of the month. They didn't say much and seemed stunned that she would suddenly act this way. They think the influence of the big city is causing her to act out. Whatever. I chose not to involve my boyfriend further because several people said that this was between us, me and Hannah, and they're right. I don't want him unnecessarily uncomfortable slash forced to do something he doesn't want to do, though he has voluntarily offered to talk to Hannah and shut her down in the past. I personally don't think it would do much to stop her anyway, given her reaction to my little lecture, so I left him out of it. I am getting a small nanny cam to monitor the apartment while I'm away, however, to make sure 1, Hannah doesn't break anything, and 2, to protect myself and my boyfriend in case she decides to make any false accusations against either one of us. At this point, I wouldn't put it past her. I seriously have to wonder if my sister is just a huge effing bitch as a result of being hopelessly spoiled, or if there is something going on with her. I really don't know, but I'm fed up with her acting this way when I did her a favor in letting her live with me. So, that's that. Hopefully I don't have to update again and she moves out peacefully. Thanks all for listening to me rant. Edit: so far I haven't heard from Hannah herself because I've been at my boyfriend's pad, but my parents tell me that she will be out of the apartment by the end of the week. Her Facebook is a whiny crying shitstorm of "life is not fair, no one understands me, you can't effing trust anybody, not even family, and my life is ruined." I have hidden her from my feed and I am going to watch anime with my boyfriend. I have already served her formal eviction papers as of today. Thank you all for your suggestions. Also, some people seem very upset that I alluded to my parents thinking my boyfriend is a catch because he is white, to the point where I'm getting very redundant PMs about it. Let me be clear, I am not white, I am Asian. However, I do not hold my Asian parents' viewpoint. My boyfriend's race does not matter to me. I think he's a catch, not for those reasons, and I love him for who he is. My parents are old school racist Asian people who objectify people, including their children, and reduce them to basic, simple attributes that are categorized into approved and disapproved. A strong, handsome white dude happens to fall into their category of yay. They also think I'll never do any better than him. So all in all, it's a pretty fucked up way of thinking for both sides. You can see why I don't talk to them much. I never condone this attitude and I'm fully aware of how racist it is, but there's nothing I can do about how they dash in a large aspect of the culture they come from dash view the world. I'm quite tired of people getting worked up about that one comment and thinking that I subscribe to that line of thinking. I do not. Thank you. Update: my sister, 18F, is trying to seduce my 24F boyfriend, 24M. I have to say my view of them has improved a little because of how quickly they acted when I told them she needed to be out. They didn't fight me on it or really blame me at all, though they didn't say much to me during the move-out process. I decided to be there to make sure Hannah didn't claim any of my shit was hers and bring it back home. I think they're ashamed that she has done this to both my cousin and me, and are realizing how shitty her behavior is overall. In a few weeks, I will visit home and talk to them about Hannah and how this really needs to be addressed before she moves out on her own for good. I've been at my boyfriend's apartment for the week since Hannah and I had our talk, so I don't know the extent of her reaction face to face. The nanny cam showed she didn't try to destroy anything, but she did have 3 basic reactions. 1, she bitched about me a lot on Facebook, to the point where I just hit her on my feed. Eventually, it got to the point where she made a specific status saying my own sister is making me homeless because she's crazy and insecure. If anyone can help me, please text me. There were a lot of responses from her little teenage friends calling me a bitch, etc. But then B, my cousin, responded with, "Don't try to make yourself the victim here. If you had self-control and the decency not to flirt with other people's boyfriends, this wouldn't happen. Grow up and have some respect." Hannah's friends all liked the comment and Hannah ended up not posting anymore. 2, Hannah tried to reach out to my boyfriend by messaging him on Facebook. They are not friends. We have a policy of not friending each other's family members so they can't snoop. I told him that it was probably going to happen, so be aware. and he told me about it right away. She wrote something like, "Ops BF, can you please talk to Op? I feel so hurt by what she's doing. I know you can convince her to let me stay. Please talk to her for me, you're more reasonable than she is. There will be something nice in it for you if you do, ugh." So she hasn't learned anything. My boyfriend only initially told me about it first, but it bugged me after a few hours and I asked him if I could read it myself, just to burn her sheer gall into my eyeballs. My boyfriend was kind of hesitant and clearly didn't expect me to ask to read it. He dithered for a while and then reluctantly let me see. It turned out he answered her but didn't tell me he'd responded. He said, "Hannah, Op is my girlfriend and it's her choice about living with you. You can't ask me to change her mind because I fully support the decisions she makes. We're a team, so please don't ever ask me to take your side against hers again. I think it's the right call for you to go home. Also, I hope to be your brother-in-law someday, so I want to be kind. But honestly, your behavior is really unflattering. It's not attractive. I just want you to know that. In the future, if you act the same way, the only guys who will find it appealing are not the guys who will ultimately make you happy or give you a fulfilling relationship. The stuff that flies in high school doesn't hold the same weight when you're older. I know you want to find a guy, but the way you act isn't going to attract anybody but the wrong people. Sorry for lecturing you, but ultimately I wanted to help you. God, I love that man." He didn't want me to read his response because he felt embarrassed that he lectured Hannah like that. But I was over the moon, especially over that brother-in-law comment. It made a crappy week so much better for me. We're currently in the talks for him to potentially move into my apartment, replacing Hannah's share of the rent and using her room as a guest bed, or getting a new place altogether when my lease is up. 3. Before my boyfriend's FB message, Hannah was also texting me. At first, it was the usual vitriol: "How's it feel to kick your only sister out on the streets? Fuck you, I can't believe you're doing this. I'll never forgive you." After his message, the tune of her text changed and got more desperate as the days went by. She began begging and pleading, saying she really needed to live in the city because it was closer to school, saying she'd do anything to stay. "I promise I'll never even talk to him or look at him again. Ever, I swear I'll change. I'll be out of the apartment all the time and you won't even know I'm there. I don't even like your boyfriend, so let's just go back to normal." I told her I'd given her a chance already and she'd flung it in my face with a big fuck you. So no, if she was going to live in the city, it wasn't going to be with me. Of course, she waited in the car throwing a bitch fit while my parents hauled down all of her stuff. So I'm not convinced this incident has really changed her in any way. So, that's it, Reddit. There was not very much drama in the week leading up to her moving out. I'm going to steer clear of her for a while and keep in better touch with my parents and see how that goes, though I'm prepared to back off as soon as they do something like regress to their old ways. BF and I are as solid as ever and I'm glad we weathered this with no drama between ourselves. I really love him and I'm glad this wasn't the typical Reddit scenario of "they were effing the whole time, boom, mic drop" type thing. So, that's it. Thanks for all of your input and support.